Konnichiwa YouTubers, this is Rest Talk straight from Japan, and today we're going to do a video review on DC Origins series number 2, Wonder Woman. And as you can see, it's a 2-in-1 package. I just want to show you the package real quick. Let me set Wonder Woman to the side. So it comes with a little collector card, as you can see in the front over here, DC Origins. I also want to show you the side artwork. I like the traditional 1930s, 1940s Wonder Woman, and here, like, she's leading the Spartans in 300. She is Greek, after all. Same artwork on the side. Show you the back over here, so you can see the lineup of heroes. And, of course, the villains, which are all awesome in their own respect. So let's go ahead and show you the main women of the hour. Let's go ahead and put them in frame so you can see them better. All right. Just move the camera a little bit, and that way we can definitely focus on the two girls. After all, that's what we're here for. Let me go ahead and zoom in so you can get much better detail. And let me zoom out a bit. As you can see, it does come with a stand. You got a 2-for-1 deal in this. Basically, you get both modern and old school Wonder Woman. Now, they have great paint applications, and I just want to show you basically good old Wonder Woman over here. Nice little shiny metallic paint finish. I'm not a big fan of the blood red lipstick, but she has beautiful eyes. Nice to you, Tierra. The hair is molded. Black hair that I so love. Just love the paint, metallic paint apps as compared to good old classics Wonder Woman. We'll show you that later. They have the same articulation and the lasso is coming loose. Here's the thing about the lasso. It is a nice little golden color. As you can see, you can store it in this little hook over here, but hey, oh well, what can you do? So nice, beautiful looking. It comes with its own stand. It does say DC 75. Put her in the back over here. As compared with the classic version, same beautiful blue eyes. Much shorter hair, as you can see. She has a lot more in the makeup, too. One thing I want to notice, same golden lasso. And actually, I don't know if you can see a little bit, but the nails do have a little bit of nail polish. So she was much more feminine in the golden era. Her lipstick's much more feminine, wears earrings. The other version does wear earrings, but they are hidden by her hair. Okay, she also has the trademark booty shorts. Junk in the trunk. She needs to start working out. The traditional Greek looking sandals with high heels. So the traditional version isn't too bad. Articulation for both versions are the same. And this is about the disappointing part about these. A real cool figure is marred by their lack of articulation, especially since these are about 6, 6.5 inch scale. And as far as articulation, head does swivel. And it's not in a ball joint. It just swivels back and forth. Arm moves around, and that's it. It's on a ball joint, so it's going to swing side to side, but not all the way out. Elbow is on a hinge, and that's it. Wrists do have that, so you can have that, the cool bracelets to deflect stuff. We have a waist swivel, but no torso swivel, and that's kind of odd. And I just want to show you, be careful when you buy your thing. Since I bought this online, it had no control, but you have some paint spotches, so that's a little bit of quality control issues right there. Great metallic finish on the booty shorts. They're a lighter blue color, more sky blue as opposed to the navy blue in the modern version. See, paint apps are a little off. It was actually, forgot when these were released, 2008, 2009, something like that. Alright, hip just goes up and down, knee just bends, and no ankle rotation. That's the same for both. And we can put them in their stands to have more support. Alright, other than that, both figures are good. If I had to pick one, I'd definitely pick the modern version over the old version. And let me put the stand there so they can actually look better. Alright, let me zoom down so you can take a look. I like the new version better. It's a lot less gimmicky, even though, I forgot to show you the paint, the paint on the boots, very nice metallic finish. Less gimmicky on the modern version. For a size comparison, let me show you with the yellow Power Ranger I've reviewed before. These are slightly bigger than a 6-inch scale, so they're more like 6.5, almost 7 inches tall. The modern Wonder Woman is taller, by scale. So it's definitely in scale because they portray her to be an Amazon and definitely taller. So the old style Wonder Woman, definitely more in the 6-inch scale. This one closer to 6.5 inches, almost 7. All right, that's all I got, YouTubers, and let me rate them individually. If you buy them, 7 out of 10, but together, because they come in a nice little 2-pack, I'm gonna upgrade that to an 8 out of 10. That's all I got, and I'll catch you all next time.